Actually, you can see three different experiments. One is electrocardiography, another one is electroencephalography, and the third one is electromyography. Okay, so this graphy, graph and gram, I have already told that different right. So graphy is the technique, gram is the output waveform, and graph is the recording instrument. Okay, so this thing you have to remember throughout your course. Okay, so not just this course, whatever course you are dealing with medical instruments, you have to remember these three terms. Okay, so first one is electrocardiograph. So, electrocardiograph. So, if you split that into three terms, electro stands for electrical activity, cardio relates to heart, and graphy is the technique. Okay. So, electrocardiography is the technique which is used to record the heart's electrical activity. Next thing is electroencephalography. So, select here, electro again is the electrical activity. Encephalo stands for brain. And graphy again is the technique. And the full experiment is electromyography. So, now what is electro? Electro is again the electro activity. Myo stands for muscle, and graphy again is the technique. So all these things, these three experiments which we are going to do now, all these things, the theory part is seen in the lecture class. Okay, so today, since it's a lab class, I thought you guys can do it virtually. Okay, so there is this website called Virtual Lab, like I said before. So if you go to that first one, it's for normal ECG waveform. So ECG is the electrical activity of the heart. Okay, so if you go to that link, so this is how the normal ECG waveform will look like. So these are the different peaks, and all these things will see it in the theory part, so you don't have to worry about that. So for the experiment, what you have to do is you have to change the waveform duration. So if you see here, previously it was 72, now I have changed it to 70. Now if I increase it, you can see that it has got more number of peaks. So likewise, you have to change and see for different waveforms. Okay, so this is your normal ECG waveform. So if you look at the second one, this is abnormal ECG. So in abnormal ECG, if you open the link, you have different conditions. On the right side, you can see select abnormality. So in that option, if you see, the first one is ventricular fibrillation. So ventricular fibrillation is one condition where your heart's ventricles won't be able to pump the blood normally. So normally your ECG signal will look like this. If the heart is having any problems, if it is not able to pump the blood properly, if the electrical impulse is not traveling inside the heart properly, then you have different abnormalities. So in ventricular fibrillation, the ventricles, there is a problem with the ventricles part of the heart. So this is the waveform for an abnormal heartbeat. Okay, so this is the first condition. Second condition is atrial fibrillation. So this is the condition for atrial fibrillation. So if you see, if I click, the waveform is changing into blue, right? So that is one single waveform. So the single waveform is repeating throughout. Okay, so this is the condition for atrial fibrillation. And third one is first order AV block. So this block is something which happens inside the blood vessels of the heart. So if the someone is having a heart attack or something, some fat layer will be deposited inside the blood vessels. So in that case, the blood won't be able to pass through the blood vessels of the heart. So there are like different categories in that. All those things we'll see when we are discussing the abnormalities of the heart. Okay, so this is the first degree AV block, and there is a second order AV block. So you can see there is a change in the amplitude and the frequency of these waveforms. Again, here also you can change the frequency of the wave. So the number of waveforms you can also change here by rotating this. So this is for normal and abnormal ECGs. Okay. And the second one experiment is electroencephalography. Encephalography is electrical activity of the brain. So this is the head and this is how you place the electrodes on the brain. So previously when we discussed the types of electrodes, I said about the different electrodes and how we are able to place the electrodes and all, right? So in this, if you see, there is a cap and it has multiple electrodes switched on that. So the person will be wearing the electrode cap. So here you have different options. So if I just play, I just click the play button, you can see for each electrode, the waveform is displayed here. This center figure, the green one, right? This shows at which location you are taking the signal. So this box corresponds to this electrode. This electrode signal is right here. So this electrode signal is here. So when you click on each electrode, you can see the corresponding waveform. Okay. So this is the recording of electrical activity of the brain. Okay. So this positioning and all we'll see in the theory part. Okay. So you don't have to worry about that. And here in this experiment, what I want you to do is you have to change the different conditions here. So this is the EEG waveform selector, right? So in this EEG waveform selector, you have to change. This is the first waveform, which is a healthy patient. So for a healthy patient, your EEG waveform will look like this. So if I change it to some left leg movement, so if I'm moving the left leg, the brain activity will change. So the waveform will change here. So there is something called imaginary. So in imaginary, what happens is the person won't be moving the parts, but actually the person will be asked to imagine the hand or leg movement. So that is the imaginary activity. So if I give left hand imaginary backward, you can see the waveform has again changed. So there is also another option here. This is to adjust the time duration. So for each 0.25 second, you are getting the signal like this. If you want to change the time here, if you change it to 1 second, each 1 second you are viewing the signal for the brain activity. And if I change it to 5 seconds, you can see the signal is having more peaks. So this is like a complicated signal to analyze. So since EEG is a very very minute and low amplitude signal, we'll always choose the minimum time period, which is 0.25 seconds. Only in 0.25 seconds you can able to see the peaks and the valleys of the EEG waveform. Okay. So here I just want you to change the different activities and observe the waveforms. You can see that waveform will be changing for each activity. Okay. And also the electrodes are placed on the left side and the right side. So when you are choosing a right hand movement, you will be able to observe more changes in the electrodes that are placed on the right side of the brain, that is right side of the head. Similarly, when you are choosing left side movements, you will be able to see changes in the waveforms of the electrodes which are placed on the left side of the head. Okay. So you change this and observe the waveforms. Okay. So this is the second experiment. And the last experiment is electromyography. So here what you have to do. So this is the recording of the electrical activity of the muscle. So this one, you are just checking the nerve conduction velocity. So in this, okay, so here what we are trying to analyze is that you will place two electrodes. Okay, so what you will be able to do, I think we have a setup here also. So when you are coming to college, I'll show you how it is done as a lab experiment. Okay, so we'll be placing electrodes on the forearm. Okay, so this is the forearm. You'll be placing two electrodes here, and here you will give a small pulse. Okay, so electric pulse you will give, minimum amount of electric pulse. And this experiment is mainly done to analyze the muscle activity. If the muscle is functioning normally, no, the electrical pulse will travel from this electrode to this electrode in a very fast way. If the nerve is proper, if the electrical activity is proper, if the muscle is not damaged, then this electrical pulse, whatever we are giving, it will travel in the minimum time and it will reach this electrode in a very short duration. So this is the normal muscle. Okay, if the person is having any paralysis, if the person has met with an accident, if the hand is not moving properly, if the hand is not functioning properly, then when you give the electrical pulse, the pulse will travel very slowly and the time taken to reach this electrode will be very, very more, will be more when compared to the normal person. Okay, so they will check for both hands. If one hand is damaged and if the other hand is healthy, they will take this EMG waveform for both hands. So if the both hands are having equal time duration or more or less similar time duration, then both hands are normal. If one hand is very having a very long time period and another hand is having very short duration, which means the one with longer duration is having some problem inside the muscles. So this is how they analyze the muscle activity. Okay, so here you can see, so this electrode we are moving, so this is like the, this red one is the electrode where we are giving the electrical stimulus. Okay, so we are just giving a small pulse and we are checking the time and also the latency. Latency is the time delay, and the velocity also here it is calculated. So you just have to calculate for each point. So you keep it here and see the time duration, and you keep it here and see the time duration. So this is the third experiment. Okay, so all these experiments you can do it in your mobile also. It's fully open source. This is done by College of Engineering Pune, so you can access all those things and you can generate the waveforms. You have any doubts in this?